Gentlemen, ladies, honorable audience, hello, I am Nadira Bellahaj, and I am here today to present the work entitled A Review of IoT Systems Engineering, Application to the Smart Traffic Lights System. To ensure the smooth running of this presentation, I will try to respect the following plan. After an introduction of the context and motivation behind this work about IoT systems, an overview of the existing methodologies to design IoT systems is followed by a comparative and synthesis study. The third point is devoted to the presentation of an extension of the domain model of the idea methodology, which is used in the fourth point to design and implement an intelligent traffic lights management system. Finally, a conclusion and perspectives will close this presentation. We are gradually witnessing a transformation of our technological. An IoT ecosystem includes five essential layers common to all IoT use cases. The first layer is represented by a physical object for gathering data like sensors and actuators. The second one is represented by a gateway that facilitates connection to the third layer, network communication. Data analysis and formatting software layer is a passage to a fifth layer called final application. This new paradigm of IoT systems challenges many difficulties, such as, first of all, the heterogeneity of the physical objects that make up an IoT system. The second one, IoT systems are hardware-centric, so it is difficult to apply software design methods. Finally, IoT systems are launched in a hurry, which could affect their efficiency. So goals targeted by this work are, first, reviewing the state of the art on existing methodologies for IoT systems and establishing a comparative study of them according to the IoT system criteria, and applying the most interest methodology and adapting if necessary to cope with IoT criteria to conceive and develop a smart traffic lights system. In what follows, we present methods that either have been defined for IoT systems engineering or existing ones have been adapted to such type of systems. There are three methodologies: IDEA, Agile IoT, and design methodology. IDEA, IoT Dev Process and App Framework, is a model-based system engineering method and one of the few methods especially defined for IoT systems. IDEA considers the model as the primary artifact for system development and is based on well-established standards. IDEA is an approach consisting of a process, methods, and tools to answer respectively the questions what, how, and with what. IDEA main constituents are a domain model and tools, IoT dev process, and app framework. The domain model is the primary artifact in the IDEA method, where an IoT application is composed of three elements: user, physical, and logical parts. The physical part, framed in orange, is composed of physical entities corresponding to devices such as a sensor, providing information and data on the physical state of the monitored entity. The physical part is exploited through the logical one, framed in blue, which is composed of virtual entities. Each one is a virtual representation of a physical entity. The domain model also focuses on the specification of system users. The part framed in yellow. A user may be human, user, or a digital artifact, example, software agent. The user part exploits the physical part through soliciting the logical. The second constituent of IDEA methodology is IoT dev process. It addresses the concerns of the various stakeholders of the system through the realization of points of view. IoT dev process approach is based on object-oriented systems engineering method. Its main steps are analyzes the system requirements, models virtual entities, defines logical architecture. App framework is the third constituent of IDEA. It is a platform that supports IoT dev process activities and provides a CSML profile for IoT applications called CSML for IoT. And it compiles very well with systems engineering techniques. The second methodology studied in this work is Agile IoT and Data. This methodology defines a comprehensive and linear process driven by a philosophy, principles, and practices summarized in what is called Eclipse Detail process. Three steps define this process. First step is a prototyping phase, followed by design and development phase. Final step for this process is factory exit phase. The third methodology is design methodology. It's an user-centric method that approaches the design goal from the perspective of stakeholders, decision makers, and potential users. This method consists of two main steps: problem formulation, formulations phase, and project development phases. Each one involves three different activities. This table summarizes the comparative study we carried out about the three methodologies. First, IDEA methodology considers heterogeneity through the CSML for IoT profile, which allows the different types of devices to be represented graphically. It also makes possible to carry out large-scale applications, addresses the concerns of stakeholders, and provides mechanisms through views and viewpoints. IDEA also offers via CSML some diagrams to assist designers at certain development phases to best design IoT systems. However, IDEA doesn't provide methods to deal with the dynamic evolution of IoT systems or for the security aspect of them. The Agile IoT methodology insists on the involvement of stakeholders in system design, but does not offer the necessary diagrams to structure the IoT system design and mechanisms to represent these needs. It considers the scalability issue and partially addresses the device's heterogeneity concern through the prototyping phases. The security concern is an important part of Agile IoT and is demonstrated through the testing, verification, and validation of each deliverable. The design methodology allows stakeholders' needs consideration but doesn't offer diagrams to structure the design of the systems. It offers an iterative process allowing the dynamic scalability of systems and their development. Heterogeneity of devices is not supported. As far as security is concerned, it is ensured through the system verification phase. However, the methodology doesn't provide means to express security needs. Throughout the elaborated comparative study, we consider that the IDEA methodology is more suitable for the development of IoT systems. To overcome the lack of tools to take charge of the security aspect, we extend the domain model of IDEA in the following section. Hence, we extended the domain model of IDEA with the new concepts related to the security aspect. This diagram depicts the realized extension. We can see that the physical and logical parts in blue on the diagram show no change from the basic IDEA model. They keep the same structure. The extension concerns essentially the user part. Road traffic management is one of the major issues of intelligent cities, with the number of cars growing exponentially, but also the rapid construction of new roads in cities. Traffic regulation has become a priority to avoid major traffic jams. Traffic management is usually done through regular traffic lights or police intervention. The application of the IDEA methodology to the intelligent traffic lights system involves the following steps. First, the requirements analysis steps, where two activities were done. First, identifying actors. For this case, there are two, motorist and traffic manager. Identify the functional requirements, such regulate traffic automatically and manually. The second step is defining an easy traffic model by instantiation of the extended IDEA domain model. After that, we define the relationships, interactions, and data flows between the different components of the easy traffic system. We have realized a prototype of the easy traffic system. It's mainly composed of the user part is composed of the motorist, the traffic manager, and also the automatic traffic management system. The logical part is made up of the desktop application. It allows the traffic manager to authenticate himself in order to access the consultation and manual regulation services. The mobile application is developed in Android and allows the motorist to access intersection consultation services. The database is hosted on a cloud server. It receives data from sensors and traffic lights. The physical part consists of the Arduino map, infrared sensors, and traffic lights LEDs. As a conclusion, we can say that we are able to study the field of IoT and define the design criteria of IoT systems, synthesize IoT systems development methodologies, extend the domain model of the IDEA methodology by security aspects, illustrate the IDEA methodology and its extension through the design and implementation of the easy traffic system. As perspectives, we think about generalize the solution to several crossroads, integrate the system into a larger smart city system, introduce deep learning to estimate fire times, establish an optimal route, assist law enforcement in reporting cases of fraud. These are some references used in this work. Thank you for taking time to listen.